वेलकम टू रोबस्ट न्यूज। एमिड कन्फ्यूजन ओवर वायरस सिम्टम्स, इसराइली साइंटिस्ट क्रिएट ए स्निफ टेस्ट टूल। स्मेल गार्लिक एंड टूथपेस्ट एंड सेव लाइफ फ्रॉम कोरोना वायरस। इट इज नॉट ए फॉल्क क्योर बट ए बेंजामिन इंस्टीट्यूट इनिशिएटिव एंड 200 पीपल आवर आर ज्वाइनिंग। An Israeli scientist is urging people to ask a simple question daily to save lives from coronavirus. Can I smell? There is widespread confusion about how to identify coronavirus symptoms, as several of them are similar to symptoms of flu and the common cold. But Noam Sobel says that there is one highly unusual pattern: sudden inability to smell, and he has built a website to help people keep tabs on their odor accessing abilities. People are signing up from all over the world at an average rate of 200 per hour. The pattern that seems to be emerging is people start to feel malaise and then even as soon as the next day have almost a total loss of the sense of smell, said Sobel, a professor at the Benjamin Institute of Science, Department of Neurology. Yes, the same is true with the cold and flu, but not to the same extent. Sobel is a specialist in the potential of smell to improve understanding of medical conditions and head of a 20% lab dedicated to this. Did not realize that smell could be so relevant in detecting coronavirus until a colleague contracted the disease. The general population talks about smell in an imprecise way, he said, but when my colleague lost his sense of smell and was able to quantify the loss in terms we use in our labs, we know that this could be used to contribute to diagnosis, he said. Sobel and his team have already translated this observation into an online tool which they say will help people tell if they may have coronavirus. They built smelltracker.org, a website available in 6 languages, where users sign up and select 5 items they have in stock at home and are happy to smell daily. Choices include honey, peanut butter, vinegar, freshly chopped garlic, and toothpaste. They receive a reminder to sniff each item each day and adjust one screen slider to rate its strength and pleasantness. If their sensitivity to an odor changes significantly, the site displays a red screen telling them that their smell is blunted. This then becomes good information for people to share with their physician, said Sobel. He has also been pioneering a technology that could help people who are diagnosed with coronavirus and hospitalized. Doctors have become worried by the sudden deterioration of some patients who appear to be in a stable condition. A small fraction of them will suddenly deteriorate, said Sobel. They will be okay and then, boom, you will have rapid deterioration. And it would be very, very helpful if that could be detected earlier. His team has adapted sensors that they have been using for their research to monitor airflow from the nose so that they can monitor changes in patient airflow, which can signal they are headed to a danger zone from coronavirus symptoms. For our research, we have developed sensitive tools to measure nasal airflow, and we have developed a tiny wearable that weighs grams and transmits data via Bluetooth, said Sobel. The wearable sensor is ready for use by coronavirus patients, awaiting regulatory approval, and Sobel is optimistic about its potential, he said. The goal is to try to catch those people one day earlier who really fall apart. This can be a matter of life and death. Thank you, audience. Thank you, listener. Please comment regarding this videos.